Thank you for making out time to listen to this innovation, wisdom field, and life transforming message from Dr. Joshua Kolawole, the Youth of Transforming Minds Evangelist with Valdymas College. Our passion is to make you a strategic innovator and help you move from a socialized mind into a transforming mind, self-transforming mind. Now let's take a deep dive into the message.
I love Valdymas.
Good morning, my dear viewers. I'm so delighted to come to you this morning. It's with great joy that I've come to you because I really want to explain something that you would need to understand for a great new year and to continue to evolve. It's called understanding strategy. And I need you to know that because of limited resources that is always around, because we're in a competitive and rapidly changing world, you will need to understand this concept of strategy. You see, strategy originated from the battlefield. It's called strategia, and it's a compound word that just describes the whole movement of the military and the whole operations on the field. And do not forget that the prize in war is such that when a nation loses, they do not only lose the lives of their citizens, their army, they lose the dignity, the pride of that nation, they lose resources. And of course, they could even become enslaved to other nations. So because of that, strategists will be very sharp in war. However, for us in the business world, in the academia, in other areas of life, maybe in not-for-profit organizations like ministries, like NGOs, you will understand that maybe because the price is not so significant, we do not pay deep attention to strategy. Or even in our family lives, in our personal decisions, we're not so clear about the strategies we follow. And these are one of the key reasons why achieving great results has been like a major issue. We need to strategically focus and narrow down so that we can achieve greatness. Look, there's a difference between just marginal, gradual, incremental gain in life that doesn't look like you're moving forward or backward. You're just growing with time. That's one side. The other side is people who actually massively change their status gradually. They massively change from a thousandaire to a millionaire to a billionaire gradually. Both happens over time, but you would want the one that has transformational change. And that's why I'm a transforming mind evangelist. I am Dr. Kolawole Joshua. I specialize in strategic innovation for you to create a self-transforming mind. Because when you do this, your personal life, your family life, any organization or institution you belong to, your nation, and of course, the whole world will enjoy. This is the reason why I come to you. This is the reason why I'm serving you. This is the reason why I want to come and impact you with knowledge such that you will understand the core concept of strategy. I will try and be very, very simple today. And please stay with me. Stay with me to the very, very end. As we go over today, I would like to use 5 A's of good strategy. And of course, this is from Valdymas College. Successful strategic implementation needs even a strategy itself. You need to first understand that. And basically, when you understand these 5 A's, it would go a long way to help you. The first one is your acumen. You see, acumen goes to deep-seated intelligence and discipline. Deep-seated intelligence and discipline. I would like you to know that anything you want to do, please, from today onward, stop using common sense. Stop using general knowledge. Start from today to make sure that you have a deep analysis of knowledge. So don't rush into doing things. When someone comes to meet you and says, okay, we need to get this project done, either in church, in ministry, in personal life, in any area or sphere of life where you belong, you must do a deep analysis of knowledge. Three things must drive you. Three things. You must ask yourself, what will I do creatively thinking differently? what I'm doing, does it have scientific basis? That's knowledge basis. Because whatever you want to do, you want it to be innovative because you're a unique personality. You want whatever you do to be differentiated. So listen carefully. Strategy would make you understand that you're not pursuing to outrightly be the best overall, but you want to be the best in the unique area you have carved for yourself. So you're going to be the best differentiated species. So Valdymas is a best school differentiated for discipline, for excellence, and for wisdom. So we have other schools. However, your family, you can differentiate it. You can differentiate your family to be known for integrity. You can differentiate your life, your person, to be known for solid character. You can differentiate your life to be known for unselfish thinking and a giver, someone who is always thinking about others. You can differentiate your family and say, we want to be a family of leaders. We want to be a family of doctors. We want to be a family of accountants. These are, but you need to do a deep analysis of the things that are required. The knowledge, the capabilities, you must be deeply aware and you must be sure that you have the skills to go ahead and make this happen. So strategy always comes with a model. And so for 2021, you need to be clear on the model you want to run your family on. Please settle down. Sit down with the family member as a head of a church, head of an organization, head of a business system. Settle down, understand the contextual knowledge, the knowledge those in your environment. You see, I have a boss who says, hire for knowledge, move knowledge, not people. Knowledge is so critical. You must have sound contextual knowledge of each person and organizational knowledge. When you match the two together, you will be able to come to, with a model. That model will help you to ensure that the capabilities of the things you would be doing would yield success. So please don't just rush into things. So, and this acumen really deals deeply with situation analysis. I want you to know that if you miss it at this point, the chances of getting it right is very slim. And don't rush with common sense knowledge. So you will need to sit down and study books. You will need to listen to messages, deep-seated messages. And that is why strategy is not just what you jump into. Strategy is deep. When the life of your strategy is shallow in knowledge, it will reflect on the kind of results you get. And that's why passionately, I'm telling you this morning, please let your acumen be so deep. Do a deep analysis of everything you do. And these are the two things, the deep analysis of the choices you will be making and a deep analysis of the consequences of those choices. And please spend more time on understanding the consequences than even the decision, because a full knowledge of the consequences of your decision would actually go a long way to alter what decisions you will be making, because consequences comes in the future, and whatever the future holds is what should determine what you will be doing now. So study people, study knowledge, study patterns, study trends, understand systems before you jump into it, please. And so moving from acumen, when you are able to solve deep-seated acumen challenges for your business, the ability to deal with all ambiguity. Every family runs on assumptions. Every system runs on some assumption. You need to check all your assumptions clearly. You need to make sure all the stakeholders involved are fully aware of the full implication and consequences. And that is why as a leader, your job is deep. It's deep. It's not shallow. The deeper you sit down and get knowledge and translate it into wisdom and into innovation, you will be able to go a long way in strategy. You must allocate resources appropriately. You must allocate resources appropriately because, you see, this is a second most important scenario. After you have a clear pattern, I push it to you today, whatever you spend your money on, whatever you spend your human energy on, whatever you redirect your material resources towards, that is what I will accept as your strategy. So I need you to know today that sometimes there's actually a difference between what people say and what they actually do. But whatever I see you push your human energy into, whatever I see you push your material resources to, whatever I see you throw your financial resources to, whatever I see you throw your time, available time into, commit your time into, those are the things I would accept. That is what comes from your heart. Your mind may be representing something else. So allocation of resources is critical. As a family, when you say you want to pursue a family with peace, and you want love to dwell in the family, then you need to start putting resources towards indicators that will show love. Maybe an example, we would have a family get together once every month. We would make sure that in the family get together, we will come with a lot of food and we'll spend like 3 hours together. We'll get the word of God or the word of or a sound teacher who would explain to us, or a counselor. You could say, okay, we'll visit a counselor once every month. You need sound things. So whatever you commit your time to, commit your finances into, whatever you push your material resources into, and whatever I see you throw your energy into, those are the places that I know you have allocated your resources into. So please do not deceive yourself and don't get confused. So for organizations, once you say we want to be the leader in technology, I expect you to start investing into technology. Invest in training, invest in teaching people, invest in buying resources, softwares, hardwares. I expect you to start using it as a template. It should be the priority for your business. And that is how you explain to people, and that's when it becomes clear. So and the next thing you would need to know is that there will be alignment and associations. Once you make up your mind strategically to position yourself for greatness, you need friends. And that comes from suppliers for a business, or even a person, depending on what you're doing. You need suppliers. You need employees for an organization. You need to be aligned with the capability of your employees. You see this quadrant. It says this is the best quadrant that gives you the best chances of winning. It is until you match your strategy effectiveness with your organizational effectiveness, then you are not going anywhere. You can see this is multi-stranded cord tied together and it becomes stronger. If you want to go singly, it would break. So going alone will never help you strategically. So you must know that there will be alignment and there will be associations. There will be people you would need to go in line with. You will have coaches and mentors. You would need to listen to messages, deep-seated messages like the one you're listening to. You will need people who will keep talking to you and feeding you with positive-minded words. Just like you eat food to gain energy, those words will drive you towards success. Those words will keep you going. Those words will fuel the passion, would strengthen your resolve. When things are not going as planned, those are the words you will lean on to receive strength to keep going. So you must understand that there must be clear balance, an harmonious relationship between your strategic effectiveness and organizational effectiveness, meaning you must understand the capabilities in your organization and you must be sure that do we have what it takes to go in this line. Number one, do you have the financial resources? Do you have the skill required? So as a family, if you're saying we want to strategically align ourselves to love each other more, then you need to gain skills. You need to gain knowledge on how to love, how families love themselves. You need to start reading books. You need to start watching programs, TV programs that aligns with that. You need to make sure there is a time, maybe every day, every other day, where you agree to things like that. And as a personal person in the academia, you need friends who are sound, who you can analyze things together, who can help you picture things in another way you would see it. That is why strategic alignment is key. And then basically in life generally, you will need access to men that will connect you. There are some men, their role is just to connect you to a greater man who will be men of influence. Sometimes these connectors, they are really not influential themselves. They are not even people you would pay attention to, as it were. You understand? They may even be just secretaries, messengers, errand guys. He might just be even a freelance guy just on the street who is not really a significant person in the society. And that's why you must understand honoring every man. You will also need, you will need men of influence who will give a stamp of their name, their word for you. And sometimes they will even give you resources. Some of them are venture capitalists who will give you funds to be able to start whatever you want to start. You would also need men that are burden bearers. Those who, when things are going down, they will always be with you. Those who believe in you, they are burden bearers. And you see, you will need people like this. I have enjoyed the ministry of burden bearers. And trust me, you will need them. So you must always have around you people who can stand by you even in shame. People who can stand by you when everything has gone down. Those are the kind of people you need. And then number four, you will need gifted, talented, and loyal men. Loyalty is superior to gift and talent. However, you need gift and talent because you could have loyal fool. And it would eventually be an issue for you to keep managing. So it's good to have loyalty, but you must have loyal, intelligently deep, skillful, and talented men. That is when you have real men. Don't just have loyalty. Also pursue talent, technical skills, adaptive skills, and deep-seated intelligence in people, please. And so I'm begging you, you will need men that will connect you. You will need the main men of influence who are either wealthy, more resourceful, experts in a field, who will give you their stamp, their authority for you to keep going. Then you will need burden bearers, those who will stand by you when things are tough, when things are not going well. They can loan you their resources. They can help you. They can cry with you. They can stand by you in shame. You understand? Those who would visit you when you're down, those are your burden bearers. And then you will need a man who are skillful, who are loyal, who are technically sound, because you won't be able to do everything and you will need all this. So you will need all this in your supplier. You will need all this in your employee. You will need all this in people, consultants around you who will be passionate about you. So you need great alignment and association to excel. You must know that for whatever it is worth, there must be action. And your action must be coherent, please. Your action must be coherent. You can see movement on this. There must be movement. There must be acceleration, please. You must, once you have clarity about what you want to do, you must be clear. You must accelerate. You must move into action and you must do everything to maintain momentum. Please do everything to maintain the momentum. So when you start something, you must keep going. You can innovate and improve on it, but you cannot afford to stop and slow down. You must keep believing. You must keep pushing on. So there must be acceleration, please. And acceleration comes with coherence. Coherence means that there's a unity between your strategic alignment, your strategic focus, the plan you have, and your strategic adaptation, how you keep adjusting to things, adjusting to real-time scenarios. Because a lot of things you will expect may not come as you have pre-planned them. Because the market can shock you as a business person. I remember Apple shipped a product into the market and they thought their Excel, Word, and PowerPoint would be the best thing. But no! They got it wrong. By the time he gets into the market accepted it as a publishing software. You understand? And so if the market calls it a different name, don't be disappointed. Calm down. So if you think you're doing a service and the market gives you another perspective as to what you're doing, accept it. And then start working on that strength to keep pushing into the market. That is adaptation. Whereas in that adaptation, you must still maintain your strategic focus, strategic alignment, and associations. So you must understand that there must be coherence. You must be able to travel at speed because speed is significant. You cannot afford something to slow you down. Imagine if a train is traveling at 100 kilometers per hour. Even if you put a block of concrete in its pathway, it will crush it and tunnel through and keep going. However, if it is running at 15 kilometers per hour, what will happen? the brick will be able to halt it to rest. So you need acceleration. And that is why in life you cannot afford to slow down. Finally, accomplishment management is key. You must know that there are four levels of conversation. There is the what that you have agreed to do. The why, which is why you want to do it. The deep-seated purpose or meaning as to why you're doing it. And then the how, the strategic how that we're doing. Immediately you get a strategic how, you move into motion, you are enjoying the excellence that comes with your success. Please ask yourself, what next? Because there's a concept called the winner's curse. The winner's curse is such that when America won the Second World War, they thought the world was on their hands. Instead of innovating and adapting and start moving, they slowed down and turned themselves to world superpower and stayed. Whereas other nations are desperately coming behind, looking at ways to disrupt America. Ladies and gentlemen, they did not come to disrupt America using nuclear weapon. Now the battle is an economic battle. Now the battle is a knowledge-based battle. So not everything will be solved by force. Not everything will be solved by fire or fight. You need to get that you can disrupt with intelligence. You can destroy with deep-seated intelligence. The only thing that will make you stay in the blue sky is when you become focused. The only thing that will make you stay in the blue sky is when you're always asking yourself, what next? I remember a book written by, I think, Tom Friedman, who is a 3-time Pulitzer Prize winner. That used to be us. I think it was a statement quoted as being said by Barack Obama when he saw China start manifesting in diverse ways, which used to be the way US was leading the world. So you must understand that a nation that fails to ask what next, a person, a family, an organization that fails to, a church, a business system, a non-profit organization, non-government that fails to ask what next, that fails to evolve into the next thing strategically, that fails to keep asking the cycle of the question, what, why, how, and what next, will soon suffer the winner's curse and will fizzle out. So per time, you must give yourself strategic goal. As a person, after this exam, I'm writing this next exam. After this, achieving this record, I'm achieving this next record. Once we hit $2 billion, we must move to set a goal of $20 billion. Once we achieve our unique proposition, on those pathway, we must narrow down and achieve a more unique proposition. You must remember that there is always this next curve. This next curve is what pushes people away from success. So imagine in the 1900s when people used to go to the Arctic Pole to get ice. They wait to the winter, they harvest ice. There was a company that was known for harvesting ice. When time changed, ice manufacturing factories were made in cities, so they never needed to wait until winter again. And after a while, the world was able to create refrigerator. And when refrigerator came, you wouldn't believe that most companies that were ice harvesters did not become ice factory in cities. Most companies that were ice factory in cities were not smart enough to become manufacturer of refrigerator. So this is what I'm saying. There will be different nest curves in whatever field you have. You must make sure you are sensitive and clear enough that as the next curve is coming, you must move with it. A typical example that comes to mind now is that the world is rapidly moving towards online academics, online teaching. A school that fails to move from didactic lecture and fails to adapt to online may soon fizzle out. It's just a matter of time. So you must understand that no matter how you improve and become excellent in didactic classes, lecture room, classroom system, with time, you will soon become irrelevant because there's already an evolutionary change. The same thing happens to church system. Online church is going to be the next trend. And so men should be ready to evolve and adjust to the next trend. The same thing happens in the world of computing. There used to be the big computer centers, IBMs of those days. Later, we had the smaller mini computers. With time, we had the desktop computers. Now we have the laptop, and now we have the phones. You will rarely see real trends in those movements. Very few companies move from the big mainframe to becoming the manufacturer of mini computers. Very few move from manufacturer of mini computers to desktop. Few move were able to manage desktop and laptop, and very few move from desktop laptop to cell phones. So what I'm saying is you must understand the next curve, and you must be ready to sink into it. So as a family, there is going to be an evolutionary trend. Every 7 to 10 years, there will be some evolutionary trend that as a family, you must be sensitive to move into. Because at a time, you will just be husband and wife. With time, children will come. With time, they will grow older. You must be able to increase your knowledge to manage the next curve. So when you are successful in those husband and wife, successful in giving birth, you must also be successful in managing those children through different phases of life. So there is always a next curve that you must be sensitive to strategically, and that is when you stay nimble and you keep asking yourself what next, and you do not allow the winner's curse to hold you down. That's why you hear stories of we used to be wealthy is a product of someone that fails to keep redistrupting himself, fails to keep looking at the future, and fails to keep strategizing. The only way you can stay in blue sky is when you're strong and you're nimble. You must be strong, you must be courageous, you must align yourself appropriately, and you must keep evolving such that if anybody comes to disrupt you, even after the disruption, you are also joining the next curve and becoming. That is the best way to go for a student, for a family, for an organization, for a nation that wants to think about national competitiveness. You must understand the next curve in every sector that matters. Agriculture has moved to precision agriculture now. With precision agriculture, there are details, very accurate alignment of everything that happens from clearing of land to harvesting of crops, in fact, to post-harvesting of crops. So you must understand and keep asking what next. That is my word for you today. So understanding the concept of strategy is to use your acumen to know what, deep-seated analysis of knowledge to know why, sound strategic associations, alignment to know how, and then to know what next. Thank you so much. I leave you with this. Expect more videos. This is Valdymas College. We're in the mind transforming business. We're building metal leaders. I trust you. I need you to know that we're the industry standard for access, quality, and relevant education. I trust you to stay with us continuously and keep adapting, keep innovating. That is who you are. That is who you are to be. Thank you so much.